It's time then for one final race in this year's Formula One World Championship. 2010 saw four drivers in contention for the title coming into this race, with Sebastian Vettel prevailing to become the youngest world champion to date. Is there one last sting in the tail awaiting us today? Well, it's time to find out here at the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. We have 16 corners here at the Yas Marina Circuit, 7 to the right and 9 to the left. It's a total lap distance of 3.28 miles. Two long straights and overtaking opportunities throughout the lap. We expect average speeds of around 123 miles per hour. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. What a qualifying yesterday for George Russell. He'll start today's race from pole position, and Teo Pourchaire completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Potter, Sainz, Hamilton, Verstappen, Norris, Fernando Alonso, Oscar Piastri, Perez, Magnussen, Gasly, Stroll, Bottas, Tsunoda, Ocon, Hülkenberg, Ricciardo, Sargeant, Albon, and Zhou Guan Yu. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today? And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. Let's talk about Potter. They've had a fantastic campaign, a wonderful year. They come into this weekend's Grand Prix as a fully deserving champion.
It really is well deserved. I wouldn't say it's been a faultless title challenge, but certainly one that has been consistent and well managed. Here's hoping they let off a bit of steam today and give us an exciting race.
Right, it's been a long, hard season. We're almost at the end, but we cannot switch off until after that checkered flag today. Let's try and end today's race on a high note. when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. We need clean overtakes or we'll get a penalty. Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the internal combustion engine. Be aware that we're going to start to see a loss of power. That we're trailing the car ahead by 2.5 seconds. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Have been a problem removing the right rear wheel. We need to try and put it behind us though, and let's finish this race strong. Look after these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. Coming in for his stop now. Gap to your teammate ahead is 28.4 seconds. Heads come in to fit the mediums. Car ahead now running medium tyres. strong, but be aware, these tyres need to go the distance. That gap ahead, please. 5.7 seconds. Gap to the car ahead, 7.1 seconds. for the race. At the moment, the car behind is lapping faster than us by around a second a lap. Race over, take care of the car on the way in.
That's it then, they've taken the win here as we wrap up another fantastic Formula One season. Anthony Davidson, help them deliver this result, do you think?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners. This result then narrows the gap between our championship leader and the rest of the standings. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
There's a few contenders, but George Russell definitely stood out, I think. A really solid drive from him today, and one I'm sure the fans enjoyed.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The owner driver's team moved to the top of the table. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today, as they make their way up the standings. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Our running costs are significantly less than the income we're pulling in. I suggest we start looking for opportunities to spend that profit margin.